Hello and welcome back to the InDesign tutorial. Today we're going to talk about references and list of references. We're also going to use a custom script to sort our references alphabetically. Finally, we're going to take a look in our text and see how we can put references into our running text. This time it's important to download the exercise files, as I have done some preparations that will make your life easier to the tutorial. So let's get started.
We start by creating a reference list, and we are going to use a table for this. You can insert a table and you need some rows and just one column. The key thing why we are using a table is, if we take one reference, for example the top one, and we place it into our table and keep each reference in one single cell, we can use a script later on to sort all our references alphabetically. So we can do this right in InDesign. We can delete the top reference in here, and then we can go to our exercise files, because there's a CSV that already contains a lot of references. So you can open them in OpenOffice, for example, and make sure you don't separate them, because you want all of them in one column. Click on OK. And then here you just copy all of them. We go back to InDesign and we insert the rest of the references. As always, we need to do some tweaks here. First of all, I'm going to create a new table style, and we call this one reference table. You can go on edit, and we're going to set up a new style for the body rows. We want to make sure that we have no spacing on the sides, and on the top and on the button, I would like to insert a spacing of 3 millimeters. In the strokes and fills panel, we're going to set the line width to 0, so we're not seeing our lines here. And then we will give this a proper name. You can go on OK, and on OK again. Next, we're going to create a new paragraph style for the text inside our table. We're going to make it based on font. And outgoing from here, I'm going to do some adjustments. First of all, I want a 10 millimeter indent. But the first line shouldn't have this indent. So I'm going to type minus 10 millimeters. We can set this as a new paragraph style. And we call this one reference. Then we're going to edit this. And we're going to use something that it called nested style. What this will do, if we set the character style bold in here, I would like to have all the names in bold. So I'm going to say through one, and then the endpoint of bold should be the bracket. So it will make everything bold until it reaches this bracket over here. You can click on OK. And now we're going to assign this paragraph style to our cell style that is used in this table. We have the ref table cell style here, and we're going to set the paragraph style references. Click on OK. Now we select the whole table by pressing Command A, and we need to click this button to clear the overrides and apply the whole style to the table. Now we can take a look at our table. I personally like to have only the last names of the authors, so I'm going to delete the V in here. And also we see there are some problems. The program I used to create these references had some data missing, so those are things that you need to watch out and that you need to fix later on. Also, the style of your references, the way you cite articles, it's up to you or up to your supervisor in which style they should be, but make sure they are very consistent overall. So use the same kind of order for all of your references. The thing we need to do now is we need to sort them. And as promised, we are going to use a script for this. If you don't have this window, you can find it under Windows and Utilities and can click here to activate it. you can go on Reveal in Finder. And this will give you the place where you need to put your script files to run them in InDesign. There's a really nice script to sort tables. It's made by Peter Carell. And I put the link where you can download the script in the description on YouTube. Just go down here and click on Show Script. To save the script, you can go on File, Save Page As, place it on your desktop. You can give it a proper name, Table Sort is alright for me, and you click on Save. Now if you look at our desktop, we have Table Sort as our script here. We put it into our folder. Then we need to change the ending. And we're going to use the ending for JavaScript. I have an old table sort script in here that I'm just going to delete. We just need the current one. So that should be it. We can go back to InDesign. And we see now we have here our table sort script. To run the script, just double click on it. And the settings here are already fine for our purpose, so we can just click on OK. It will take some time, and now we have our references sorted alphabetically. I think this looks nice. Next, we're going to talk about how to put those references in our running text. Also, the references in our text should have a nice and consistent formatting. One good rule is to keep all names in small caps. We have already a character style for this, the ref style, and we can apply this to names. If you now have a sentence where you think you need a reference, and you have this reference in your reference list, you would take the name of the author, and then the year of the publication. You see now that the formatting, small caps, was automatically applied to name. This is because we have something included in this document that is called GREP styles, and this is in the paragraph style basic text, it's included in here. And we're going to talk about this in a later tutorial, because it's a little bit more complicated and advanced. The only thing important for you to remember right now is, if you don't have a GREP style, you need to apply the character formatting by hand over this panel, and if you want to use the GREP styles, you only need to make sure to have a consistent style of formatting. What this means, for example, if I have two authors, I always use this AND symbol to type in the second name, and if you have more than two authors, you don't write all the names, you just write the first one and type et al. And this is formatted as well. If you have for a sentence several references, you can just write down a semicolon and write the next name. And again, when the publication was published. You see, GREP styles are taking a lot of work away from you. So enjoy placing your references.
Alright, that's it for today. And in the next tutorial we're going to see how to export your whole thesis and put it in the PDF document to have it print ready. So until next time, bye bye!